Time now to connect the dots when we make the news make sense. 100 days to go, but make no mistake, folks, the world will still be battling COVID-19. Even if much of the U.S. is in a much better place, smaller, less developed countries will still be struggling. Organizers of the Olympics, though, are adamant the games must go on.
After a one-year delay, the world's best athletes will compete this summer. But COVID-19 will loom large. Let's connect the dots. The best seat to watch the action is really the only one. On your couch watching WCNC Charlotte. No international fans will be allowed to attend the games. The 11,000 competing athletes will be told to arrive late and leave early. And they'll be kept from hanging out in groups or visiting Tokyo's tourist hotspots. As for the games, the new sports are karate, surfing, and something called sport climbing, where athletes race up various types of walls. Expect to see some familiar faces. Simone Biles, Kitty Ledecky, Ryan Lochte are expected to return, but you won't see Olympic superstars Usain Bolt or Michael Phelps. Both men are now retired. Opening ceremony set for Friday, July 23rd. They'll air live at 7 a.m. right after Wake Up Charlotte. And if that's not enough Olympic activity to get you in a gold medal mood, the Winter Games in Beijing, less than 6 months later. And that is Connecting the Dots.